All right, so we're going to do this review of the 2-5-1 progressions. I thought those were, you know, phenomenal songs to use, especially that that one from Alicia Keys. That was a really good one. So, well, the Chance one was good too. It had a lot of 2-5-1s. Okay, so here, let me show you this. Okay, there's in your canvas, there's this little document. Okay. All right, so let me explain it. This is what I want you guys to do. It says, it's basically, it's a 2-5-1 modulation exercise. And so when you see it, so for example, it has these two lines here. And so that means those are going to be quick chords. So this, like, first chord, this one here, E minor seventh, is, you know, for two beats. Then we have a chord on 3 and 4 going to B minor seventh. And then the C major seventh is for two beats. Then we have a quick, you know, 3-4 going to A minor seventh. So when you're doing these kind of like modulations, you want to use the, let's just do the first two. Okay, so if we're going E minor seventh and we want to go to B minor seventh, okay, so what we're going to use when we do that, we're going to use the, you know what? I should have probably put a half diminished in there. So this has got to be a minor seventh, oops, flat five. And yeah, so you have to fix it in yours. Yikes, it's pretty big. So we'll do it this way. I don't need to even use that. So it's minor seventh, flat five. Okay, so that's going to be like the half diminished chord. I don't think I have a symbol like this triangle here. So what would that be in B minor? What would be the 2 minor 7 flat 5 chord?
C sharp.
Yep, C sharp minor 7 flat 5. Go into what would be the 5-7? That would be a dominant seventh chord of B. Right, F sharp seventh. So that's what you would put in here. So you would fill, you could go to Canvas and download this thing now, you know, and fill this out. Okay, so it would be, okay, C sharp minor 7 flat 5 to F sharp seventh. Okay, so then when we have C sharp or C major seventh, okay, Evan, and we're going to A minor seventh, what would the chords be here? Again, we're going to be, whenever you're going to, you know, a minor chord, you're always going to use that half diminished thing.
So
that'd be
C major 7.
Then it goes to the A minor 7.
Okay. So I have to transition to A minor.
Yeah, you have to do the transition. So really the only things that make a difference are where the lines are going into that next chord. I just kind of created progressions that would be somewhat, you know, like common.
Okay. So would it be a D?
No, it has to be a 2 of A minor.
Oh, so I was looking at
B minor 7 flat 5. Go into what chord here?
C.
No, it has to be the 5 chord of E. A.
Oh, E. E.
E7.
Or E7, yeah.
Right, it has to be E7. Okay, let's do a few of these. Okay, so Ryan, let's do this next one. So we're going F, C major 7 to F major 7, but when you do these, you just use a regular minor chord.
So it'd be G minor 7th.
Right.
And then 5th of
F. What's the 5 of F?
That'd be C...
7th.
C7?
Yeah, C dominant 7th. All the 7ths are going to be dominant. Okay, so, all right, so let's do this next one. Going to B flat major 7th, John. Okay.
So you'd have a C minor
7th.
7 to a F7.
Perfect. Okay, let's do the next one. Taryn, A major 7th.
You'd have a B minor 7 to a E dominant 7.
Right, okay. Let's do this one, Deanna.
E minor 7 to A7.
Okay, Graham, let's do this one. It's going to F minor 7.
G minor 7.
Flat 5.
Flat.
Yeah, because whenever you go into a minor, you want to use the minor 7 flat 5.
Okay.
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 To half diminished chord.
C7.
Yeah, C7, right. Okay. Mike, let's do this next one to D flat major 7.
It would be C flat minor 7.
No, it has to be the two of this.
E minor 7, E flat minor 7.
Right, E flat minor 7, 5 would be.
The 5 would be B7.
No, it has to be the 5 of D flat.
B flat 7.
No. It has to be the 5 of D flat. What would be the 5 of D flat? Look on your key chart.
It would be A flat.
Correct. A flat 7. Right. Hey, Lendon, let's do this one. Okay, see, going to A flat major 7. The 2 is what?
Major 7.
Which one?
D major 7.
No. It has to be the two of A flat going to A flat.
A flat.
What is the two of A flat?
B flat.
What? Minor 7.
B flat minor 7.
Right. And then the 5 is?
E flat.
Yeah, E flat 7. Okay. Yeah, so when you're using, again, 2-5-1 progressions are always, they're either minor sevenths to dominant sevenths or they're half diminished sevenths to dominant sevenths, okay? So that's kind of what we saw in those two songs that we were, working with, last time. And there's lots of examples of using those kind of things. And actually, these are a good set of progressions. They might be fun to actually, play on something on guitar or keyboards, just to kind of, but fill this up. Send it to me. All right. Okay, I'm gonna unshare. Alrighty. So, okay, here's some songs for today. All right. So that's gonna be in this canvas. Maybe I'll fix it too, so it says minor 7 flat 5. In case you get the mistake in here. Okay, this is a song. An interesting song that John sent in. So I'm gonna play this. I'm gonna share it. Okay, here goes.
You need great marketing videos to grow your business. With Promo, you can create commercial level.
I'm going to go back one. Let's go here. Okay, who was that?
Steve I or Satriani?
Satriani. Yeah. Did you know Steve I studied with Satriani?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was.
That's why I was guessing between the two.
One of the two. Those two only sound the pretty much the, they got that sound down. I mean, Satriani's one of the best ever, you know, for that sort of stuff. So tell me about that. What did you kind of notice about that song? What would you say, Graham?
Was it like C. Lydian?
Yeah, it was C. Lydian. Yeah, it had that, you know, that kind of pedal, you know, thing going. You know, that thing, that was cool. Okay, but then what else kind of did it do? Anybody else have any other, like, observations? It kind of modulated, didn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, here, let's go to just that one section right at the beginning. Okay, what would you say went on there? What did he do? Any guesses? Were there any guesses that you have on that, or what he did to that other section? Because he was doing that, you know.
It went up to G or G sharp?
G sharp.
Yeah, I wasn't sure.
So he basically took. So what he did is he just went to the A flat, and then he pedaled on that, and then he superimposed a B flat chord over that to go into A flat. So is there any symmetry there compared to the other section? I mean, what was the chord in the main section? It was what chord was that?
That was G flat, the F sharp.
Yeah, that was D. It was a D chord to a C, with C in the bass. Kind of that pedal kind of thinking, right? So if I had a C in the bass, and then I played the D and then the C, okay, that's totally Lydian. Then what he did in the next part. He just took the same thing of it, but A flat in the bass. Okay, like that. So, how would you describe that movement? What is kind of going on with that? If he uses the same, like, two chord to one chord, like in C, like D to C, then he went B flat to A flat, which is a 2-1 in key of A flat. Is there a name for taking an idea and moving it?
Sequence.
sequence, right. So this is a great example of taking a sequence of a progression and just moving it around. Again, totally major. Okay, he's got four major chords kind of, you know, in a row there. So, but again, it's using that kind of sequence. He sequenced the Lydian scale, you know, here. Okay, so that's another, again, what the point of the class is learning tricks, okay? Learning how to do tricks for writing, you know, and taking, and so one of the tricks here is taking an idea and sequencing it and moving it around, leaping in a sense to another key. You know, that's kind of what he did. I mean, the B flat, A flat would be, if you had C as the root, what would those chords be? B flat and A flat. They would be what? Major chords from what?
E flat.
E flat, right, or C minor. Okay, so again, that's a little bit of the reason why it probably worked, because it has that, you know, almost like minor sound. But back to again, and there's a lot of like, not only sequence in the chords. Let's listen to just this little section again, but just listen to the melodic ideas sequenced here. Okay, cool. So cause there's a lot of ba 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 ba. Those kind of simple little ideas, they hold things together. Okay, they make these kind of key changes believable. They make it so that you, when you're you know, listening to this, you go, oh yeah, that makes sense. I buy that. You know. So again, a great example of Lydian. Thank you, John. Yes, you know, and again, not only Lydian, but leaping Lydian. Okay, so that's another concept I want you guys to, like, this is the kind of the concept du jour is the leaping. Okay, so now I'm going to play another song. Here it goes.
I got a bone to pick. I don't want you monkey mouth, cause sitting in my throne again.
Hey, it was headed, back in the hood.
I'm mad, but I ain't stressing. True friends, one question. Where you and I was walking, now I run a game, got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off him. Kunta, black man taking no losses.
Oh yeah.
Where you and I was walking, now I run a game, got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off him. When you got the yams,
what's the yams?
The yam is the power that beat, that beat, that beat, that beat, that beat. You can smell it when I'm walking down the street.
Oh yes we can, oh yes we can.
I can dig rapping, but a rapper with a ghost rider, what the f*** happened?
Oh no,
I swore I wouldn't tell. But most of y'all sharing bars like you got the bottom bunk in a two-man sale.
A two-man sale.
Something's in the water.
Something's in the water.
And if I got a brown nose for some gold, then I'd rather be a bum than a motherfucker.
Oh yeah.
Where you and I was walking, now I run a game, got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off him.
King Kunta,
black man taking no losses.
Oh yeah.
Where you and I was walking, now I run a game, got
got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off. When you got the yams, the yam brought it out of Richard Pryor. Manipulated Bill Clinton with desires. 24/7, 365 days times two. I was contemplating getting on stage just to go back to the hood, see my enemy and say, where you and I was walking. Now I run again, got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off. King Kunta, black man taking no losses. Oh yeah. Where you and I was walking. Now I run again, got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off.
You goat mouth mammoth.
I was gonna kill a couple rappers, but they did it to themselves. Everybody's suicidal, they didn't even need my help. This shit is elementary, I'd probably go to jail if I shoot at your identity and bounce to the left. Stuck a flag in my city, everybody screaming Compton. I should probably run from mayor when I'm done. To be honest, and I put that on my mama and my baby boo too. 20 million walking out the court, baby, woo woo. Oh yeah, the judge, I made it past 25. And there I was, a little nappy headed nigga with the world behind him. Life fake, but a fat screaming, Annie, are you okay? Okay, limo tenant with the gold play straight from the bottom. It's the belly of the beast, from a peasant to a prince to a king. Oh yeah, where you and I was.
By the time you hear the next pop, the funk shall be within you.
Now I run the game, got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off. King Kunta, black man taking no losses. Oh yeah, where you and I was walking. Now I run the game, got the whole world talking. King Kunta, everybody wanna cut the legs off.
Mike, tell me what's going on in that song.
Well, that was King Kunta by Kendrick Lamar. And I noticed there was like almost this walk down in most of the song. Like it's sort of just like... there's a minor sense to it almost.
Yeah, it is definitely minor. Okay, Taryn, what would you notice?
Well, the biggest thing, I think everyone noticed this, but like it went from it went from like E to F.
Yeah.
It felt like.
Yeah. Kinda. Definitely. So what was the main scale of the bass? Would you say
it was E minor.
E minor, right. Probably E minor pentatonic too.
Mm-hmm. I just played E, it played F sharp though.
Okay, all right. Okay, six tone minor then. Okay. So then but then it went up to what?
F major.
No, not F major, same thing. It went up to F minor.
F minor.
F minor.
Yeah. Okay. So what happened there? It, what's the word? It
modulated.
It, yeah, modulated. It, I used the word earlier today. It's the
sequence.
Another word.
Leaping.
Sequence leaping. Okay, so you take an idea, you know, it was the same exact bass part. You know, the thing about the song is that bass part is super strong. I mean, it's real basic, but the groove of it is just, you know, slamming, you know, so, but they take, you know, that basic, you know, minor bass line with the drums, and then they scoot it up a half step. Okay, now that's not a necessarily closely related key, okay? When you go from E minor to F minor, there's a lot of different notes. Mm-hmm. But it's easy to do on guitar, you know? Okay, I mean, it's easy to do on any instrument, really. So, but it's still an idea where they're just scooting, they're bending it up a half step, okay? That's another trick. To be able to see, now I don't think the song would have been as good if they didn't do that. You know, I think if they just kept it in E minor the whole time, I think it would get okay, all right, okay. But by going by building it up that half step, what did it add to it?
Some,
what'd you say?
Like
just some funk.
Interest.
A little tension.
Tension, a little tension, okay? And kind of resolve. It kind of made you, oh, okay, it shifted, you know? There was another kind of thing in here, too, that was interesting that we talked about last week. That was something that happened kind of midway through the song. And then it was real strong the rest of the song. Did you catch? Here, I'll play the section, see if you can find what I'm talking about. Okay, what'd you hear?
The high register had this sort of like pedal tone riff
going. Yeah, it had a riff going. Okay, it was it a hard riff?
No, it was simple.
Okay. Okay, so it was what? It was a high power chord. Is what it was. It was just E and B, you know. But was it strong in the song? I mean, did you hear it?
Yeah, I definitely heard it.
Yeah, it was definitely there. It was definitely a really compositionally a strong part of it. Okay, it was something that drove it, you know. It's still, and again, there was a lot of bands that were doing things like kind of in the late 90s, early 2000s. And really even probably after that too, probably even in, you know, the mid like 2010s and stuff like that, where they would be four piece bands, where they'd be two guitars, drums, bass, you know, and then you would have guys doing just like kind of power chords, you know. You know, that kind of stuff. And then the other guy would be doing. You know, kind of like a drone riff or something over the top, you know, but then the power chords are going on underneath it. You know, it had to be both guitars playing at the same time, you know, to kind of create the effect, kind of like Green Day-ish stuff, you know. And but still, again, it's like using a riff to kind of hold it and to glue it together, you know. And so those, so don't underestimate simple, you know, because there, so again, we've got to do some simple little pedal tone riffs at the, on top. And then they just, but they leaped up a half step and then back. Okay. All right. Here's a pretty wacky one. This is going to take a little work. Let's see. Mike sent me this one. I'm not sure. It's only 8 minutes long. I'll play not that long of it, but here we go. We'll be right back.
I wish I remembered how to play that.
Okay, obviously, who was that?
Metallica.
Yeah, of course. Okay, so tell me about that song, Deanna. What would you say about it?
I thought that it was an E.
Major or minor?
Minor.
Okay, E minor-ish. Okay, mm-hmm. What else about the song? Just tell me about like some of the like if so you were saying, you know, just describe the song. Is this a like a does it, you know, like just tell me some of the elements of it, you know, like of what's kind of makes up this song.
So like when he said master, like when it like would go up a half step, it was kind of chromatic like that.
Okay, so what if it was E and it went up a half step, that would be what?
F natural,
which would make it what kind of scale?
Phrygian.
Yeah, it was a kind of a Phrygian-ish, you know, sound. It wasn't totally Phrygian. It's mostly minor. Hardly anything that I'm going to be giving you guys is, you know, if I say, is this diatonic? You go, no, you're probably right, you know, okay, because it's always going to be migrating now. I mean, we're in the upper level theory stuff here. So there's going to be a lot of migration. Okay, so, but what else did it do that the other songs did today? It
leaped.
Right. It leaped up to what? Grand.
E to F, right?
No. What were we talking about?
When did
F sharp?
F sharp. Yeah, it went up to F sharp. It went up to a whole step. Okay, so the difference is this one leapt up to a whole step to F sharp minor and did the riff. Then it went back down to E minor, just like. You know, like the Kendrick thing went from E to F minor. This one went from E minor to F sharp minor and then back down. Again, this is almost impossible to learn by me playing it through the internet. You know, it's no doubt. These are not like, okay, I'm trying to get you to play these songs. All we're doing is do overviews. These are just overviews of the general concepts of the song. Okay, what other things could you tell me about the way that they structured the song compared to some other kinds of styles of music? This was very much oriented in two words, blank, blank.
Riff-based.
That's very riff-based, exactly, totally riff-based. And what type of, but also another thing that was in here a lot, which is really like the bread and butter of metal.
Power chords,
tons of power chords, you know, that kind of stuff, you know. So then had the power chords, very fast power chord riffs, okay, also, you know, very riff based song. There's not like situations where they're, you know, jamming out on some regular open chords. It's a very riff based approach to writing, you know. But again, it had, you know, some, if you were going to say its main flavor would be what?
Heavy metal.
Yeah. What type of metal
flavor? Riffs.
Riffs. And it's mostly, Deanna said it.
Power chords.
And one more.
Riff based.
Power chords. What kind of flavor? When I talk about flavors, I'm talking about scales. What kind of scale?
E minor
or
Phrygian,
right. It's a Phrygian kind of scale. So we had some modal stuff today. We had, you know, when we were dealing with Satriani, that was Lydian. This one was a Phrygian one again. So we're interspersing modal things with kind of the other leaping idea. Okay, so sometimes you have a great idea and you just move it up just for fun, you know, just like they did in this one, just to kind of give it contrast. Because so much of keeping people's attention is having something that keeps them, you know, there's some contrast in it that gives them, you know, something to listen for, you know. And again, this is super, you know, committed music. You have to be, you know, to play this kind of stuff, you really have to be into it. You can't just kind of be mellowing out, you know. And so, okay, so all those three songs are in the chat if you wanted to copy them. Okay, let's see. I got another one. There's two songs I want you guys to kind of, I'm gonna put them in the chat. You might want to like copy these, and I want you to listen to them for next Wednesday. Okay, let's see. This is a classic song too, and I want you guys, I'm not going to just play it, I want you guys actually maybe spend a little time with it. It's by John Mayer. It's this one here, Georgia Y, okay? And then the other one is going to be by Led Zeppelin called Kashmir.
Oh, yeah, dad tuning.
Well, whatever. It's still, you know, there's, I want you guys, these are the two. Okay, so copy those out and basically, I want you to, I guess I can't now. But here's the Why Georgia Why, just a little bit of it. There's some really interesting things going on. This is a classic song, and it's almost in the like level of, you know, Blackbird in terms of, you know, the way it moves around and, you know, just the melodic ideas and the chord structures and stuff. So here, I'll play a little bit of that.
Inside the gloom, four more exits to my apartment, but I am tempted to keep the car and drive and leave it all behind. 'Cause I fill the spaces with world in places to make it feel like home. But all I feel is alone. It might be a quarter life crisis, but just a stirring in my soul. So I've got a smile on, but it's hiding the quiet superstitions in my head. Don't believe me. Don't believe me. When I say I've got it down.
Okay, so I want you guys to copy that URL, and I want you to just like, you know, mess around with that song, you know, during the next couple of days, just to see what, so what elements kind of did you, if you were going to just like globally say, what do you think happened in that song? Obviously, it's not diatonic. Okay. What were some things that went on?
Switch from major to minor, or minor to major.
Where?
I don't know, maybe I'm wrong.
Okay.
There was something right at the end where it like kind of did something weird.
Okay, that was some different kinds of extended chords. He uses, John Mayer uses extended chords, which is nice. It's that's cool. Okay.
There's there's a lot of like dynamic variation throughout.
Okay, dynamics. Okay, what else? Generally.
Leaping,
exactly. There was leaping. I tried to make continuity. Okay, so it was leaping. Okay, so there was definitely leaping. He was leaping out of the key. Okay, and there was a couple places he did that. Okay, so I want you to kind of find where they do that. There was also, it was one of the best examples of a pivot chord. I want you to find it in there. So when you look for it. Okay, I'm going to play this one little section of this song too. And I'm sure you're familiar with it. They've made a ton of money on this song, you know, for movies and stuff like this. And my guess in this song is, I want you to tell me, there again, there's a lot of notes in the air in this song, but I want you to tell me the one note in the chromatic scale that's not in this song. Okay, but again, we'll do that Wednesday, but let me just play a little bit of it. Okay, I'm sure you guys have heard that, and probably some, you know, some intense movie. And so again, I'll put those both in not only during the chat, but I'll put them in Canvas, you know, both of those things. And so anyway, I want you in Kashmir just to find the one note that's not in it. Don't say it if you know it. Okay. Okay, so you have to write it down or put it in a little doc for me in the email. Okay, so again, what I want then, for, you know, I want you to work on those 2-5-1 progressions that I put in the documents. And then I want you to like listen again for, you know, in the John Mayer song, and then Kashmir, we'll talk about that one, those two Wednesday, just kind of your analysis of those. And what's the operative word of the day?
Leaping,
right, leaping, taking a riff and leaping and having sequence. Okay, sequence was also very important. Sequence is taking an idea and leaping to some other place, okay, where you have a melodic or chord progression, that a phrase that, you know, moves. Okay, again, these are all tools for composition. So, okay, leaping and sequence. Okay, see you guys, and we'll talk to you again Wednesday.
All right, see you.
See ya.
Take care.
See ya.